Good morning all. So in the last class, we discussed two problems. Okay. So given a mechanical system, finding the displacement you have drawn the equivalent mechanical network, and based on the given problem, you have find out equivalent mechanical FE analogous network or FI analogous network. Okay. So today we'll continue the problem. Okay. So the problem will be given either FE or FI. Some cases both can be given. So such one problem we have. So draw the FE and FI analogous circuits for the mechanical system shown in figure with necessary equations. Okay. So equations are necessary here to write the network. So that sometimes they will mention it, sometimes they won't mention it. Okay. So now this is the network given. So yesterday in the notes, the three problems were there, I think. I don't know how many of you have copied. Okay. So you have to do. Okay. Otherwise difficult to proceed. So this is the third problem. It is there already in your notes. If you are not written, after this session you can write down. Okay. Now if any new problem I will do, I will share that PDF to you. Okay. So in this problem now, so previous two problems you have seen only two displacements, x1 and x2. Okay. So now in this problem there are three displacements are there. So one is with m1, another is M2. So because they only have given displacement, and since spring and friction are connected in series, there is one more displacement comes. So this is another thing you have to remember. So yesterday I have learned when mass is there, there is a displacement. Okay. And in all the cases, you had only single element with the mass or the surface. Okay. So now here spring and damper are connected in series. So there is in between, because spring is also having some movement, right? So when you try to push with this M1, so there is in between here also displacement. So that's why this is X1 with M1 and this is X2 is shown, and this is third displacement X3. So now you have identified the displacement. So now you draw the three dots X1, X2, X3 and a reference node, and then start drawing the equivalent mechanical network. Okay. So you are going to do both here FE and FI. So the first thing is same. So equivalent mechanical network, and you have to write the equations of mechanical equations. Then for FE analogy, we'll use the corresponding equivalence. For FI analogy, corresponding equivalence. Okay. So both you know. So just we'll revise it. Okay. With this problem. So the three displacement I told you, x1. X2, X3. So I have taken like this because X3 is present between X1 and X3. So that too easy to draw the network. Okay. So no need that you have to write X2 only here. No need like that. So in the problem, in case if here X1 and this was X2 and this was X3, this was X1, X2, X3 like that, then you should have written in the same order. But while taking only, you have taken X1 here, X2 here, then X3 we have taken here. In the same order we'll take, because where force is there, that will take normally first, then is X3 is there, then X2 is there. Okay. So then masses with respect to X1, you have the M1, with respect to you have the M2. Okay. So that you have to connect first, then force is connected to X1, then remaining. So B1 with respect to ground, then K1 along the path M2, X2 is there, and then B3 along the path X3. And X3 to X2, you have the K3, and there is no self element of X3. Okay. So there is no self element of X3, which is mutual only. Then at X2, K2 and B2 you have. Okay. So that only written here. So X1, X3, X2. At X1 side, you have M1 and the B1 and the force. And between X1 and X2, you had the K1 that is shown like this here. And in between X3 is there. X3 and X1, you have the B3. And X3 and X2, you have the K3. Okay. And at X2, you have the M2 already, along with B2 and K2 are in parallel. So this is your equivalent mechanical network or nodal network for mechanical system. So from this, we will use the Newton's law of motion and we'll write these equations. So first node now. Okay. So first node, which is at X1. Okay. So all the things we need to write down here. Okay. What are the, how many terms will come? 1 f of t b1 m1 then b3 k1. So 5 terms will come. So first one is here, f of t is equal to, then m1 is there, so x square term we'll write first normally, d square x1 by dt square, because it is x1 displacement now, plus b1 is there here, b1 dx1 by dt. So these two are the self elements of x1. Then K1 is present between X1 and X2. That I have written next. K1, X1 minus X2. Then B3 is present between X1 and X3. And B is associated with first order difference equation. So B3, dx1 by dt minus dx3 by dt. So this is your equation 1. Okay. Hope you understood how you write. So then we'll go to X2. Okay. So X2 will go. So X2 again, you have 5 elements. M2, B2, K2 and K3 and K1. Okay. So first, there is no force at X2. So it is 0 equal to M2 d square X2 by dt square. Okay. Then B2 is there dx2 by dt. Then K2 into X2. This is a self. Okay. Then you have K1 and K3. So first I will write K1 X2 minus X1. Okay. And then K3 X2 minus X3. Okay. So in this path. So this is about second equation. Okay. Second equilibrium equation or necessary equation. Third thing. So at X3 you don't have any force. So again it is zero. You have only two elements here. One is B3 and K3. And both are mutual. So that's why B3 dx3 by dt minus dx1 by dt at x1 side plus k3 x3 minus x2. Okay. The remembering is along with mass, you will have the d square term. Okay. Along with b, you have the d by dt term. Along with k, you have the x term. Okay. If you know this and if you have the diagram, so you can easily write the equation. So this becomes your equation 3. Okay. So if you have understood yesterday's session and you have written down the notes, okay, seeing the video or by this one notes. Okay. So you are able to understand what I am discussing today. Okay. So now what is the next step? FE analogous network. For that FE analogy, you have to apply for these three equations. Okay. So you have these three equations. So just I will apply the FE analogy. For FE analogy, you know, wherever force is there, replaced by V, M into L, B by R, K by 1 by C, X is there, integration of I, okay, dx by dt is there, just I, d square x by dt square is there, then di by dt, okay. So now we will apply these two, three equations. First equation, f of t place, I have written V of t, okay, I will tell, okay, so that you will understand later, okay, V of t. M1 into d square x1 by dt square was there. So it is L1 di1 by dt will come. Then B1 dx1 by dt was there. So R1 into I1 will come. So then you had the K1. K1 into x1 minus x2 was there. So it is 1 by C1 integration I1 minus I2. Plus you had the B3 into dx1 minus dx1 by dt minus dx3 by dt. So that becomes R3 here, B3 place. And dx1 place, you will get I1 minus I3. So this is your equation number 4. Okay. So with respect to the equation 1, I hope you are understanding. So if you have already written down the notes, so that you will just try to understand. Okay. Have you got the equation? So similarly, you have to substitute in equation 2 and 3 also. So 0 was there left side. So then M2 was there. So L2. D square x2 by dt square was there. So it becomes di2 by dt. So then you had the b2. So it will come r2. Then dx2 by dt was there. So it is replaced by i2. Then you had k2 into x2. So that is 1 by c2 into integration of i2 dt. Then k1 was there. So 1 by c1 i2 of i2 dt minus i1 dt. Okay. So just it will take the time. So just I2 minus I1 is shown. Okay. So this dt should be written normally. Okay. Write down that. Then you had the K3 with respect to node 3. So that is 1 by C3 into I2 integration I2 minus integration I3. So this is your equation number now 5. Okay. Then finally, the third equation you have to substitute 0. So you had only the mutual elements. So B3 was there, R3. Dx3 by dt minus dx1 by dt was there. So it becomes I3 minus I1. So then K3 was there. So it is 1 by C3. Then dx3 by dt minus dx2 by dt was there. It becomes integration, x3 minus x2 was there. So integration I3 minus integration I2. So this becomes your equation 6. So now look at the equation 6. Okay. As I told you yesterday, for FE analogous network, always you have to look at the equation. Okay, because you have drawn the equivalent mechanical network of nodal analysis and you are writing now mesh. So when you are writing that, So first you need to, and always when you have three equations and when they are mutual by just looking at this diagram. Okay, so just try to show you. So there is something you have to apply. See here, x1 is there, x2 is there. If this x3 was not dependent on x1, then you would have written three planar networks, one mesh, second mesh, third mesh. But here x1 and here x2 is there, in between x3 is there. That means x1 and x2 also dependent, x1 and x3 also dependent, x3 and x2 also dependent. So this is some common idea it will give. So from this, how to draw the network, you will get an idea. So that's why here 1, 2 and down I have taken the third mesh. Instead of taking this mesh here, what I am saying, instead of taking this mesh 3 here, okay, I have taken here. Why? Because 1 to 1 they are dependent. Okay, first what we'll do, first the self elements will try to do it. What are the first mesh? If you see, so there is M1 and B1 is there. Okay, so that is nothing but L1 and R1 are the self elements, and V of T is it's the self. Then coming to mesh 2, you had M2, which is nothing but L2, then B2 was there, R2, and then one K2 was there. So instead of writing 1 by C2, just write C2. This is the self. Okay. So then between 1 and 2, if you see the nodal network there, between 1 and 2, that is X1 and X2, you had the K1. That means C1. So you have to show the capacitor here. So little mistake I have done earlier. So that is not. Okay. Remove this. It is just capacitor C1. So which is common. So then between 1 and 3, between 1 and 3 only B3 was there, that is nothing but R3, and between 2 and 3 you had the C3. Okay, so this is your FE analogous electrical network. So when you draw the networks, problem will come. So no issue, just first rough work you use, okay, rough work you do, and then you give the final shape. Okay, the final answer you put it over here. Rough work, just try to do it with pencil also, okay. And then you put the clear picture. Okay. So since I am showing the result, so hope you understand that what I am saying. Okay. So by seeing the network, this network only, you have to identify that. Why I have to draw like that? Because one to one, it is interdependent. Okay. Because of that, this mesh I have shown here. Otherwise, it will be shown right side. Okay. One, two, three, like it is called as planar network. This is not a planar. Okay. And then show the I1, I2, I3. So this is your network. Hope you understood. Now the same equation 1, 2, 3. Same equation 1, 2, 3. I will apply now FI analogous network. Because we have to do that also, right? 12 marks question, not 8 marks now. So the two steps where it will come. So till here it is 8 marks. Now writing this equation 2 marks and the network marks 4 marks. So that's why it is 12 marks question. Fine. So now FI analogy, what will happen? The same equation. Wherever F is there, I will replace it by I. M is there, replace it by C. B is there, 1 by R. K is there, 1 by L. X is there, integration of V dt. Dx by dt is there, V. D square X by dt square is there, dV by dt. Okay. So if you have written down that, just you can see the equation. Otherwise, what I am saying, just try to understand. And later on, you write. Okay. So first, F of t place, I am writing I of t in the case of FI analogy. Then M1 place, I am writing C1 now, okay? Earlier L1 used to write in FE, right? And then D square X1 by DT square was there. It is DV1 by DT now. Then B1 was there, so 1 by R1. DX1 by DT was there. It is V1. Then K1, X1 minus X2 was there. So it is K1 is 1 by L1 according to this. And X1 is nothing but integration of V1 and integration of V2. Okay, so this is the little changes will happen. Then you have the B3, nothing but 1 by R3. And then DX1 by DT minus DX3 by DT was there. It is V1 minus V3. Okay, so this is the equation number now 7. Okay, 4, 5, 6 was FE analogy equations. So we'll give the new equation 7, 8, 9. Okay, this is the equation 7. So next second equation, we'll substitute this analogy 0. M2 is there, C2. D square x2 by dt square is there. It is dv2 by dt. Then b2 was there, 1 by r2. dx2 by dt is there. So that's why v2. Then k2 into x2 was there. So that's why 1 by k2 plus 1 by l2. x2 plus integration of v2 dt. Okay. So then you had K1 into X2 minus X1 was there. So 1 by L1 integration V2 minus integration V1. Then K3 into X2 minus X3 was there. So 1 by L3 integration V2 minus V3. Okay. So this is the equation number 8. Because there are three Ks are there in equation second. That's why you will have L1, L2, L3, all three. Okay. Then final equation, the third equation, you have 0. B3 you had 1 by R3. Then dx3 by dt minus dx1 by dt was there, which is b3 minus b1. Then you had k3, x3 minus x2. So k3 is 1 by L3, x3 plus integration of v3 and x2 plus integration of v2. So this is your equation 9. And you know that writing FI analogous. So next step is writing FI analogous network. You can use the same first equation. Okay, the first network what you have used, the same thing you can use. Because it is also nodal analysis and this is also nodal analysis. Otherwise, another way you have to do is just observe this equation 7, 8, 9. Okay. So what you have to do? So here these two are the self. C1 and R1, they are in, belongs to node V1. Okay. And I1, I of T is connected to that. Then between V1 and V2, L1 is there. And between V1 and V3, R3 is there. Okay. Like that. So you have to draw the network. So this is the same as previous one I told you. There I have taken everything is common ground. Now the ground part is all together connected. Okay. Same as first network. So instead of x1, we had here v1 of t now. In the place of x2, I have shown v2 of t. And in the place of x3, I have shown v3 of t. These are the three nodes. Okay. And there is a common node you can show like this reference node. All are connected to this ground. So then m1 place, you have replaced c1. B1 place you have replaced R1, F of T place you have replaced I of T. So then K1 is present between X1 and X2. You have to write it as L1 now. Between V1 and V3 there was B3. So you have to replace it by R3. And between V3 and V2 you had the K3, replace it by L3. Okay. And then V2 side you had the M2, that is nothing but C2. Then B2 was there R2. And then K2 was there L2. Okay. So I hope you have understood this. FEFI both analogous network. Okay, so this is the first set of problem you have in module 1. Okay, so the plenty of problems are there, you need to solve that. Okay, so I'm doing much problems here because just you have to practice it. Okay, so by referring the mechanical system, you have to draw the mechanical network from their equations. From equation you have to do the analogy, from analogy you have to draw the network. So one to one there is a relation is there, so that you will practice it. Okay, so I have a few more problems. See, this is all translational system I have taken. Next, I have the rotational systems also. Rotational mechanical system also. TV analogy and TI analogy we told, right? So that also we'll see. Before that, we'll take another set of FEFI problems. Okay. So just read out this question. Okay. So this is the latest one, 17 scheme. Okay. Latest question. June, July 19 question paper. Just I will note down your attendance. You read out the question and have a mental picture. So how you can solve this, how the equivalent mechanical network will come. Roughly you can do, just mechanical network you can do. Done. Okay, we'll continue. So in one class we can solve maximum two questions. So one I have done. So this one we'll see. So question will be asked like this also. For the mechanical system shown in figure, draw mechanical network, write differential equations, write the forced voltage analogous electrical network. Okay, So this is 2 mass, this is 2 mass, and this is 2 plus 2, 4 mass. You have to write the equations, right? So this is 8 mass question. Okay. So now there is a, so previous one you have seen verticals like, right? So M1 above M2 was there, like that it is one. So question can be given in any manner. So this is now horizontal way. So just to show you, I have taken this set of problems also. Okay. Either they can give like vertical type or the same question, they can put it in horizontal way also. Okay. So this is the mechanical system, put it in horizontal way. Okay. So you had two masses here, M1 and M2. Okay. So then there is a K1 is present here. So F of t is connected and B1 is present between M1 and M2 and K2 is also present. Between M2 and the ground, you have the K3 and B2. So now X1, X2, X3, well, how much displacement they have not given. So this is one tricky thing you have to identify now. Okay. So if you observe, then there are two masses are there, definitely there are two nodes. Okay. X1 and X2 you can say. But now here F of t is connected to K1 and K1 is connected to M1. That means before mass M1, there is a spring. So spring is having some potential energy, right? So because of that, you can see some displacement also in K1 also. Okay. So that is possible. So chances of X3 you have to take. So just we'll see the mechanical network of this. So that is three displacements, right? So X1. So X1 side, it is only F of t is connected. Okay. And between X1 and X2, you have K1. So that I have not shown you here, right? So just I will show you. So how you have to take. So here you have the first displacement X1. Okay. So just imagine some mechanical system you have connected and you are pulling that. Okay. So you are pulling the goods vehicle, something. Okay. So spring, it will have first movement, right? Then this will move, right? So this will have the displacement. I denoted H2. And then the spring and damper are connected. And then it is connected to M3. And the third displacement you will see at M2. So that's why X1, X2, X3. Okay, so since F of t is connected X1 side, so first X1 dot will write, then X2, then X3 and the reference node. Okay, so that is what the equivalent mechanical network you have. So X1 of t side only K1, one side K1 is connected, another side F of t is connected. So F of t is shown like this. Then between X1 and X2 only K1 is there, that is drawn here. Then between X2 and X3. Okay, at X2 you have M1 is connected and no other things are there. So B1 and K2 are present between M1 and M2. Nothing but X2 and X3. So that we have shown as parallel. Then at X3 you have M2 and then B2 and K3 are there. They are connected to surface. That means ground. So this is the equivalent mechanical network. Okay, so they give you vertical type of mechanical system or horizontal. So no changes will happen in the mechanical network or writing equations. Now quickly you can tell the equations. Okay. So differential equations, first one. Okay. So what you have, F of t equal to, you have only one element which is mutual between X1 and X2. So it will come as equation K1 into X1 of t minus X2 of t. Okay. So X1 minus X2 also you can write. So this is your equation one. Very simple. So then second node, that is X2, there is no force connected here, so that's why it is zero now. And M1 d square X2 of t by dt square. Then two elements are connected mutual. So first K1 is written X2 of t minus X1 of t. Then B1 dx2 by dt minus dx3 by dt. And sorry, this K1 is along X1 side, that we have written first K1 X2 minus X1 t. Then here B1 and K2, B1 dx2 by dt minus dx3 by dt, K2 x2 of t minus x3 of t. So this is your equation 2. Okay. So total 1, 2, 3, 4 elements are connected. That's why you have 4 terms here. 1, 2, 3, 4. And this is 0. No force are connected, 0. Similarly here now, x3 side, 1, 2, 3 self element and 2 mutual. So total 5 terms you should get here. See here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the clarification. Okay. You have to check once again before moving next. So this is 0 here, no force are connected. Then M2 is there, M2 d square x3 by dt square. So one confusion what you will do is normally M1 along with X1 will come, M2 along with X2 will come. But in this our diagram, x1 is taken by k1. Okay, that's why m1 will have now dx2 term and m2 will have dx3 term. So this should be Cauchy's. Okay, so while writing, that's why your presence of mind is very important. So by simply you should not write m2 is there, that's why x2, no. So it's all depends on the network figure, and from there only you have to write. So m2 belongs to x3, that's why m2 dx3 by dt by dt square. B2 dx3 by dt, again here also b2 into dx2. So because this is the, you know that, but in exam hurry you will be making these mistakes, because of that you lose marks. Okay, so that's why cautious about that. Then k3 x3 of t, okay, k3 x3 of t. Then b1 and k2 connected between b1 dx3 by dt minus dx2 by dt. Then k2 x3 of t minus x2 of t. This is your equation number 3. I hope after solving this third, fourth problem, now you have cleared how to write the mechanical network. Maybe you are learning something new, but remaining all three steps are, it is same as previous. Okay, so only the idea you have to put it here in the first step, how you write the equivalent mechanical net. That also very simple. Okay, identifying the displacement, and if you follow that 6 steps, it is easy. Okay, so now we'll write the FE analogous. For that, FE analogy will apply for this. So M into L, this is a step you have to write. Okay, otherwise you may do the wrong things. Okay, so B into R, K into 1 by C, F into V, X into integration I dt, dx by dt is I, d square x by dt square is di by dt. Okay, so first equation you had the F of t, V of t, K1, X1 minus X2 was there. So 1 by C1 integration I1 of t dt in minus I2 of t dt. Okay, so previous case I have shown you just integration of I1 minus I2 also. I have shown you I1 dt, I2 dt also. Now I am showing I1 of t dt, I2 of dt. So if you does not write this also, by default, these are all time domain equations. Okay. So in this case, I have written, this is the complete one. I1 of t dt, that means it is time variable. Okay. So normally in hurry, we will not write that. I1 into dt, I2 into dt will write. Some cases, integration of I1 minus integration of I2 also will write. Okay. It's okay. Because time, it is consuming time. So that's why we'll have that habit of writing. Okay, fine. Just a minute. Okay. So we'll go to equation number 2, same way. So this equation number 4 you give. Okay. So then this equation 2, you had 0, then m1 into d square x2 by dt square was there. So it is L1 di2 by dt. Okay. Again, here writing also you should be careful. Okay. Simply L1 is there, I1 you should not write. Okay. Cautious about that. Then k1 into x2 minus x1 was there. So it is 1 by c1 integration of i2 of t dt minus integration of i1 of t dt. Then b1 you had between x2 minus x3, dx2 by dt minus dx3 by dt, which is r1 i2 minus i3 you will get. Then k2. X2 minus X3 is there. So 1 by C2 and then integration of I2 dt minus integration of I3 dt. So make it as equation number 5. Then last equation 3. Okay. 0. M2 was there. L2. D square X3 by dt square was there. Di3 by dt. Then B2 was there. R2. Dx3 by dt was there. I3. Then K3 X3 was there. So 1 by C3 integration I3 dt. Self elements, then mutual B1 was there, R1, dx3 by dt, I3 minus dx2 by dt, I2. Okay, the plus K2 was there. So K2, x3 minus x2 was there. So it is 1 by C2 integration of I3 of t minus integration of I2 of t dt. So this is equation number 6. Hope you have understood. So again, now writing now the 3 loops. See your previous problem. Previous FE analogous and this one you see. Okay. So the previous problem, today's previous problem we have seen. I have drawn the third loop below. But in this case, I have written one after the other. Why? Because of the network here. So there is no dependency between, dependency is present between 1 and 2 and 2 to 3. There is no dependency between 1 and 3 here. Right? So because it is just a flow. Okay, 1-to-1 mechanical systems are connected. So there is no connection between 1 and 3. That's why you can draw like this. So first self elements you see. So with respect to first loop, there is only V of t was there, F of t. And then K1 was there. So K1 is C1 now. Okay, which is also not self-element, which is mutual between 1 and 2. That's why it is come and sit over here. Understood now? So it is common element between first loop and second loop. That's why it is C1 here. Then for the second node displacement, only M1 was the self-element. That's why it will be there here, L1. Okay. If another self-element was there, you can show it in down also. Okay. So wherever space is there, you can write, or you can serially, you can show like that. Okay. Only one is there. That's why L1. Then between in X3 of T, you had M2, B2 and K3. Right. So three elements were there. That is L2, R2 and C3. Okay. Then mutual element between 2 and 3 was two elements. That is R1 and C2. That is shown here. R1 series with C2. Okay. So this is about the FE analogous electrical network. So hope it is clarified to you. So I can take another problem, but only 6 minutes are left out. So we'll take up in next class, or else I will just give you that problem quickly so that you find in the notes, you can write down that. Okay. So quickly I will show you that. Hope you understood this FE analogous network 8 marks question. Okay. So just go through this question. Okay. So this is also recent question, December 19, January 20, last January question paper. Okay. For the mechanical system shown in figure, write the mechanical network equations of motion, force, current, analogous electrical network. Okay. So there is something within the mass you have that. Okay. So just look at the picture and how you can have your equivalent picture. Only thing you have to focus is where should be the displacement. Okay. So that also shown here. That's why no need to worry. Even if they have given just how it will be x1, x2, x3, how it they have taken, just have an analogy. Okay. So take time to understand this. Okay. Because only the first step is important. Remaining three steps you can just write up. Okay. Only the first step you need to focus. So that I try to show you. Okay, so how you got this? So you have M1 here and you have the M2 here, this is inside this, and then this is the M3. Okay, so where is the force applied to M3 now? Okay, M3 is applied, force is applied to M3, and this is connected to K2 here. Okay, K2 to M2. Okay, then M2 to M1, there is K1 as well as friction B1. Okay, and between M2 and M3 there is a friction B2 shown here. Okay, and between M3 and the ground there is a friction B3. So all these things you have understood. Now you have to draw a mechanical network. So just have x1, x2, x3. Okay, and connect the damper and spring along their position, but mass should be connected to that displacement node and the ground. Okay, so this you know. Just show the equivalent mechanical network. So at x1, m1 is connected. Okay, so just see the diagram. So just here m1 is connected. Okay, and then k1 and b1 along m2. Okay, and that is x2. K1 and b1 along x2. At x2 only m2 is there. At x2 only m2 is the self element. Then that is connected to x3 by k2 and b2. Okay, this is K2. Okay, this is K2 and this friction B2. M1 and M2 or X1 and X2, this K1 and B1 are the frictions. Now at M3, so X3, this is M3 and this B3 connected to ground. So M3 and B3 connected to ground. And now force is connected to X3 of T. Earlier you have seen problem, it is connected to X1, right? Now it is connected to X3. So this is also possible. Okay. So just same way you write the equations now. The remaining part I will give it to you. I will send the PDF part of this. Okay. So you write down. Okay. And try to get the equations. Okay. How you got this? So this mechanical network I have explained you. So write the three equations, then apply the FI analogy, write the corresponding equations. Finally, you will get the FI. It is simple, right? Whatever you have the network here, just you are writing there. Okay. Nodal analysis. So V1 what you had, V2 what you had, V3 what you had. The same network, it will be there in FI. Okay, only thing is you have to, how to write the equations. This you should practice it. Okay, so we'll stop for here. So tomorrow I will take up from here. So if you have done, you have understood, I can skip this and go to next problem. Okay, so work out on this. Okay.